snap, burn, chainsaw.
It was hard thinking he actually got shot by a real bullet from a real gun, from a real person.
I absolutely wish I was still in the Army. I had an identity, and now, who am I?
I don't know if it's PTSD, but he's not engaging with us.
Everything's stressful. He's a lot more on edge lately.
You're not the one banging into frickin' door jams every day.
I'm not sure his injuries were worth it all.
How long do I stay motivated?
I think I'm definitely going to college, and he doesn't believe me. I do want to have kids eventually, and I don't want my kids to go through what I went through.
Hey everyone, Rick Hong here for Hollywood First Look Features. Today I'm with directors Leslie Davis and Katrin Einhorn for their Netflix film, Father, Soldier, Son. Ladies, I wanted to tell you congratulations. Getting any movie done is not easy, or any film done actually. And I just wanted to know right at the top of my head, how much did you cry doing this documentary?
We cried a lot. And as journalists, you know, we're taught not to show emotion, right? When we're working, we really try to hold back that. But there were certainly, I mean, some of the very devastating things that we captured are humanity. I mean, we wept alongside the family.
Did it take a lot of convincing to get Brian signed on? Or how did the two of you figure out this is the story that we want to tell?
So, Brian, initially when the reporter from the New York Times at first met him, approached him, I think that he was resistant to being followed by journalists, as many people are. And then after that, it did not take, he was not resistant at all. He's actually quite open and really enjoys sharing his story. So I'll let Kat talk about how the project started in 2010.
A team of us at the New York Times were following one battalion of soldiers during their year-long deployment to Afghanistan. So, you know, President Obama was doing his troop surge, sending in 30,000 additional troops to try and end the war. And Brian was one of many soldiers that we profiled. But his boys were just so captivating. I mean, you know, after we met them, they just stayed with us. And so much started happening to Brian in the months after we met him, and then in the years after we met him, that we went back and we continued telling his story.
So I was just trying to figure out from the time the both of you sat down and said, okay, this is the documentary we want to do. We think this is the story. How much did that change from beginning to end?
We had no idea. Like, you know, the joy and the sorrow that we were going to witness. You know, we set out in 2010 to tell a story about, you know, the consequences of war on these two little boys. And how were these little boys who, you know, so far away from Afghanistan, in their own way, they had been deployed because they had to leave their home in New York and go to Wisconsin with their uncle because their dad was a single dad. And so they were sort of, they were living with the anxiety of what if their only parent, the only parent in their lives, you know, really traumatic for them. And then, you know, Brian ended up getting injured, fought to save his leg, ended up having to have his leg amputated. And we realized, wow, we can tell a story about how does war actually continue to shape a family? Because there have been so many, you know, so much journalism and documentary around, you know, veterans coming back and the wounds of war on individual soldiers and service members. But like, how does it play out in a family? Like, how does it ripple through these relationships? Does it reshape things in like big and small ways? That's what we really wanted to explore. And then their lives, you know, we never thought it was going to be 10 years. It's just that, we had to keep telling the story.
So I was trying to figure out when you get it done and, you know, Netflix wants to distribute this and that Netflix is at where it's at now, what do you two do to celebrate?
To celebrate, we had a couple of toasts on Zoom. And I think Katrin went to the beach yesterday for probably the first time this year.
That was not a celebration. That was appeasing my family so that my poor husband didn't divorce me and my children didn't like divorce me as their mother. So that was really just like, that was doing like returning to my family and giving it, you know, the love and attention that my husband and kids needed. But along the way, you know, Les and I have sometimes when things happen, like when we've had little victories along the way, we do have a little tradition of drinking a margarita together.
We used to get sandwiches, so it's a nice evolution from sandwiches to margaritas.
Well, I just wanted to tell you both, congratulations. I respect, you know, being like having to sit there and try to do a film and just do it for so long, because I'm a guy that needs immediate like satisfaction. So congratulations, you did a great job. The film is Father, Soldier, Son. You can stream it on Netflix now. Until next time, I'm Rick Hong, and you've been watching Hollywood First Look Features.
You always think back, would you change something or would you have done this different?
Just keep going.
That's all you can do. And fill your days with more happiness than sadness.